actually a decent size too. Like a small chanterelle. Well, they are chanterelle, but I mean a small golden chanterelle. And I just leave these little tiny ones here so that they can keep dropping spores. When you find them, you tend to get quite a few of them. They're kind of like horn of plenty that way. But yeah, they're like open areas or needle mat like that. So in younger forests, hemlock, pine, fir. Let's have a little look around here, because I bet you there's a bunch more. Now these guys are way more pale, almost like a cream color. Typically they're more of a bright yellow, but they vary equally delicious. These guys are a little bit paler on top. They're also a little bit more full grown, but you can see the difference there at least. Those guys have more of a bright yellow color. Just a couple there. These are my favorite stomping grounds, close to home anyways. Nobody goes up here. Hikers and stuff, but I've never seen any pickers up here. Which is awesome. They actually have sort of a plain color. They're a lot smaller than golden chanterelles, but I find the flavor is equally as good. The texture's kind of neat. You gotta get a lot of them, but this is what they look like. Usually they're a little bit brighter in color, but it's really cold out the last couple days, and they're more like that. But some clusters kind of vary that way too. Here's a couple nice yellow ones there. So yeah, when you find these, you just kind of look around. They like mossy areas, stick mat. They kind of grow all over. They're the rocks. Grow in pretty good sized clusters. Sometimes you'll find them grown individually. But when you do find them, just grab them out of the base of the stalk. You can pull them right out of the ground. They come out really easy. They don't pull up huge strings of mycelium or anything. Or you can just kind of snap them. They snap right off too. What I do is take the really nice meaty ones and just leave a couple so they can continue to drop spores.